Good morning, students. Today, continue the session linear programming problems. Okay. Today is a different kind of problems, that is verbal problems. So they are not going to give the problems directly. Okay. We have to formulate the verbal problems mathematically. Then we have to find out. And then we have to solve the linear programming problems. This graphically. Okay. First, I'll read the question because it is it takes space so much. So I'll just read the question. One kind of cake requires 200 gram of flour and 25 gram of fat. So and another kind of cake requires 100 gram of flour and 550 gram of fat. Find the maximum number of cakes which can be made from 5 kg of flour and 1 kg of fat. Assuming that there is no shortage of the other ingredients used in making the cakes. Okay, here talking about the cake, the ingredients, there are two types of cakes, no? Called as the first kind of cake as the eggs and the another type of cake as white. For this type 1. So this type 1, consider this first type of cake as X and this second type of cake as Y. Okay, we have to consider X and Y. This is the first kind of cake and this one is the second kind of cake. So here they are given. So here there are two types of cakes. Okay, just write that. So number of cakes, number of cakes. Okay. So this is the flour required. Okay. It is in terms of grams. Okay. This is grams and fat required. Okay. Fat is required in terms of grams. So there are two types of cakes. That is first kind of cake as considered as X and the second type of cake as considered as Y. Here there are two types of cake, no? That is first cake and two types of cake. First type, second cake, second type. Here number of cakes start as this, we have called this as X and this as Y. So what is the flour required? So to make cakes, so we want the flour as well as this fat, no? The ingredients of this cake, making cake, that is flour. How much flour is required in terms of grams and how much fat is required for to make a cake, okay? So how much flour they are given in the problem itself, okay? So one kind of cake requires 200 gram of flour. See, one kind of cake is, that is first type. We have considered as first type as X. It required this 200 gram. Okay, 200 gram. So 200 is, it is in terms of grams, no? 200 cakes we have to make. Okay, 200 gram of flour. So flour is required. 200 gram of flour is required and 25 gram of fat. This one is 25. X. So to find first kind of cake, there are variety of cakes, no? That the flavor is going to differ from this kind to kind, this first kind to second kind. So there, in this first kind, we have considered the cake as X and what is the flour required for the first kind of cake, that is 200 gram X. And fat is required for 25x. Go for second kind of cake. So second kind of cake we have considered as the second cake. That is to consider as Y. What is the ingredients are required? Okay. And another kind of cake requires 100 gram of flour. 100. Okay. So this is 100. This is flour. We have considered as second kind as Y. Okay, 100 Y. 100 gram of flour required. And 50 gram of fat. Okay, 50 gram of fat. Okay, so we have to formulate the question. How we are going to formulate the question? First, we have to read the question. Okay, what are they given in the question? We have to read the problem. Okay, so there are two types of cakes. The first type of cake we have considered as X, and the flour required for first type of cake, that is 200 gram, that flour is required, and this 25 gram of this fat is required to make first kind of a cake. What about the second kind of a cake? So we have considered second kind of cake as Y, that is Y. So it requires 100 gram of flour and 50 gram of this fat is required to make second kind of cake. We just add the total, okay? Total, there are two types of cakes. After adding this, you get X plus Y. And what about this one? 200 X plus 100 Y. And this one is 25 X plus 50 Y. After this, we have to add the this flour requirements, and for both of this, this both for first kind and second kind of the cakes. Here also, what are the fat requires? We have to add the inequalities, the equations we have to add. Okay. So after this, we have they are given. So this is the total number of cakes. Maximize, that is equal to x plus y, such that we have to find out, such that, so we have to write this one, 200 x plus 100 y less than or equal to, see, here you will find the maximum number of cakes which can be made from 5 kg of flour. So 5 kg of flour, okay, 5 kg. So for this equation, maximum number of flour is required for this 5 kg, which is equals to 200 x plus 100 y less than or equals to 5 kg. 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams. Because it is in grams now, we have to convert this kg as in terms of grams. Okay? So 5 kg, 5 into this 1000. This equals to 5000 grams. Okay, 5000 grams. It is in grams. This requirements are in grams. Okay, so cancel these two. You will get 2x plus y less than or equals to 50. Okay, that is one inequality we have got. What about the second inequality? This 25x. Okay, 25x. 25x. Plus 50y less than or is equals to, what are the given? So find the maximum number of cakes which can be made up or made from 5 kg of flour and 1 kg of fat. Okay, this 1 kg we have to write. Okay, after this, 25x plus 50y less than or is equals to 1 kg. We have to write in terms of grams now. Because it is all we have written in terms of grams. So in kg also we have to write in terms of grams. Okay. So after this, how many times? 21za, that is 2za. This is 4 times. 25 into 4. Okay. 5za, 20. So, okay, this is 4 times. So what is the equation we get? X plus 2y. Less than or is equals to this 40. Okay, this 40. So we have got the equation as x plus 2y less than or is equals to 40. So mathematically we have to write, this is the mathematically we have to formulate this problem. Okay, so mathematically we can write the statement as maximize. Okay, maximize. So this is very, very important. Okay, maximize z is equals to x plus y subject to the reconstructs. Subject reconstructs. So what is the first equation we have got? This one now. So subject reconstructs 2x plus 5 less than or equals to 15 termed as equation 1. So what is the second equation we have got? That is x plus 2y less than or equals to 40 termed as equation 2. And we have to write the non-inequality also. That is x, y greater than or equals to 0. That is x greater than or equals to 0, comma y greater than or equals to 0. Because there is no shortage of the ingredients over here. So we have to formulate this verbal problem mathematically first. We have to formulate this problem, this wording problems mathematically. After that, you know how to solve the system of linear equations by this graphical method, okay? This is the formulation of this verbal problems. So one kind of cake requires, there are given, you know, this is how much fat is required and how much flour is required. So that now what are the given, we have to write the table, we have to put the table and write all the values, okay? Try to formulate the question mathematically. Okay, after this we have to maximize, because find the maximum number of that is k, then given k. We need to find out this maximize, okay? How to find this maximize by using this? In the earlier class we have told these are called the inequalities, okay? So this is the inequality. This is a non-negative constraints, okay? You have to remember, because in the examination, definitions are coming, I have told you already. So it is coming for 1 mark in the definition. So definitions, there are only 5-6 definitions, okay? You need to be practiced. So these are the this x, y greater than or equals to 0. It is a restriction. This is non-negative constraints. So these are all the restrictions. Subject to the constraints. Constraints are nothing but restrictions. That is linear inequalities are called constraints. So these are the linear inequalities now. Less than or equals to, greater than or equals to are called linear inequalities. These are the constraints. We can also call it as linear inequalities or this one restrictions also we can say, okay? So these are the constraints. This is the non-negative constraints, okay? So linear inequalities are nothing but restrictions, okay? So according to this, we have to find out the maximum value of this, okay? So how to find the maximum value of this? You know, we have to first draw the graph of the line, no? We have to just draw the graph of the line. Which is the first line here? So, this is the first line. So, call it as this one. 2x plus y is equals to 50. So, we have to write in terms of sentences. Draw the graph of the line. 2x plus y is equals to 50, okay? So you know this, okay? So call it as x, okay? If I substitute x is equals to 0, you get y is equals to 50. Y is equals to 0, you get 2x is equals to 50. 2 1s are, 2 2s are, 2 5s are. X value is equals to 25. This is the graph of the line. 2x plus y is equals to 50. X is equals to 0, you will get y is equals to 50. Y is equals to 0, you will get the x is equals to 25. After that, substitute x is equals to 0, y is equals to 0 in equation 1. So 0 plus 0, which is equals to less than 50. Is 0 is less than 50? Yes, it is less than 50. Which is true, this equation is true, okay? Which is true. If it is true, the half towards the horizon. The line is going to be like this, okay? The half plate is towards the horizon, okay? This is the half plane, okay? In the first classes we have discussed half plane, lower, left half plane, right half plane, upper plane and lower plane. Now we have discussed, no? This half plane, the solution contains towards the origin. It is going to be towards the origin. If we draw this line, no, we have to put the lines like this, okay? This is the line, we have to draw the lines. The shaded part is going to be like this, okay? This is going to be true. You have to write the sentence, okay? This is the third class we are doing these problems. You have to write the solution contains towards the origin. Whatever should go for the second one. What is the second equation? So x plus 2y is equals to 40. Second, you have to write, draw the graph of this line, x plus 2y is equals to 40. When x is equals to 0, y is equals to this. I can write x is equals to 0, 2y is equals to 40. 2 1 2 2 2 y is equals to 20. So y is equals to 0, you get x is equals to 40. Okay? Put it in the table, okay? This is the value of x. X is equals to 0, will give y is equals to 20. Y is equals to 0, x is 40. So substitute x is equals to 0, y is equals to 0, you will get 0 less than or equals to 40. So this equation is true. So it means that the solution contains towards the origin. So if it is towards the origin, you have to draw the shaded part. It's going to be like this. Okay, you draw the line like this. After this, if it is the solution contains towards the origin, means you have to draw the shaded part is like this. Okay. If it is equation is not true, it is away from the origin. No? If the equation is not true, this is not going to be satisfied. We have to write like this. Okay, this is the one vertical slanting line. You put the lines like this. Okay, away from the origin is away from the origin. So after this, okay. So this is x is equals to 0, y is equals to 0. According to this, we are going to draw the graph, okay? Okay, this is... So you just see the values, okay? You can give the areas like this. You can put the scale like this 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. X value is like that, no? Y value is also up to 50. You can add 10, 15, 20. Okay. 10 also, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So these kind of problems we have done already. These kind of linear programming problems we have solved. Okay. So change the scale. X is equals to that is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Here also we put the scale as like this. Okay. So x is equals to 0, y is equals to 50. Yeah. Okay. Immediately write the coordinates of the point, because after that you get confusion. So better write after putting this value, okay, pointing this value, no? X is equals to 0, y is equals to 50, and x is equals to 25. 25 is coming somewhere here, no? That is 25 comma 0. If it is y value is 0, just join the lines, okay? Like this. After this, how we are going to shade the part? So we have to, that is towards the origin, the solution, the half plane. This is the half plane, no? So the half plane is going to towards the origin. Origin is here, no? So towards the origin. Then go to the second graph of the line. X is equal to 0, that is 20. Here, next 40. Okay, here, immediately write the points, that is 0, 20. And what about this? 40, 0. So, just draw the lines, okay? Here. Here also, okay? The solution contains towards the origin. Towards the origin. You have to draw the line like this. This is the line, no? This is the line. So, this is the line. So, below the line, you have to draw the line. This below, this should contain towards the origin. So, what is the shaded part here? What is the physical division? So, where is all the point is going to be coincide? So this, no, you just consider which is the first line, this one, no? This is the first line, okay? Where the lines are like this, and the second line is like this. Here also the lines are. So here, these, no, in this part, all the two lines, all the inequalities is going to be satisfied here, okay? Here. Coincide diagram, okay. So this is the shaded part. This is the feasible region, okay? This is the feasible region. So feasible region, that is feasible region is nothing but common, that is a solution region. The common region determined by all the constraints, including the non-negative constraints is called the feasible region. This is the feasible region or solution region. By looking this feasible region only, you will come to know whether you have done this graph correctly or not, okay? So if it is feasible region is correct, your graph is correct. Otherwise you won't get any marks, okay? That is you get 0. Instead of 6 marks, you will get 0. This feasible region has to be correct, okay? After this, which is the main point we have to do? So the main point is now we have to, this is various intersection here. So here now, this is draw the vertical line. Get the point as 20 and this horizontal line you get 10. So this is much very important. I have told you already in the earlier classes. So drawing this corner point, getting this corner point is very important. Intersect, what is corner point? A corner point of a feasible region is a point in that region which is the intersection of the two boundary lines. So which is the intersection of the two boundary lines? This one, no? This is the intersection of the, this is, of course, it is a feasible region. Intersection of the two boundary lines is the feasible region. So this is 0, 0, 0, 20, and this one is 25, 0. So these are the corner points. After this, immediately you have to write the corner points, the coordinates of the corner points will get marks for this for that, okay? So the coordinates of the corner points are 0, 0, 25, 0. Here it is 25, 0. And this is main thing, you have to write it properly. Here only will come to know whether your graph is you understood the topic of this concept or not. So this is 20. Go for this vertical line, you will get it. From this intersecting point, now from this intersecting point, you just put the dotted lines like this. Where it is going to be? It is going to be 20, at the point 20. Here you put the dotted line towards left side, that is horizontal line, you will get this point as 10. So the coordinate of x and y, this is the x value and this is the y value. X is 20 and y is 10. So this is very important. Okay, after this you write just the coordinates of the what? The coordinates of the corner points are. So the coordinates of the corner points are. What are the coordinates of the corner points? This 0, 0 and this 25, comma 0 and this 20, comma 10. What about the last one? 0, comma 20. So the coordinates of the corner points are like that. You have to write. Okay, you have to write all the coordinates of the corner points. After that, you have to find out maximum or minimum value for using the objective function. Right? What is the objective function? So it is also a definition. No, it is coming in the examination. This definition is also very very important. Objective function, a linear function. Z is equals to ax plus by, no, where a and b are constants, which has to be maximized and minimized according to some set of given certain conditions is called the objective function. So that is the definition of objective function. A linear function, z is equals to ax plus by, where a and b are constants. No, this is a. So, where a and b are constants and x and y are the decision variable, they are going to decide which is going to be maximum and or minimum. So, x and y are decision variables in this objective function. It is a linear function which has to be maximized or minimized according to some certain set of conditions is called the objective function. You should know all the definitions, no? You should know the definitions, okay? Then you'll get 7 marks for this chapter. Graph is for 6 marks and this definition is for 1 marks. So, try to understand the definition. Okay, write the definition properly in the examination. And after that, this graph is very, very important, okay? So, after this graph, coordinates of the corner points, we have to find out the maximum and minimum value. Okay, you can put serial numbers also if you want serial number. So these are the corner points. No, after the corner points, next z is equals to x plus y. Here the equation is x plus y. So which are the corner points? 0. We will put the serial number 1, 0, 0. You can put this, you can name this also, you can, for this you can make up the names. This is A, B, C, D. And this A, B, C, D is bounded, okay? So this, it has to be this bounded region problems, okay? This one is bounded. Of course, this one is bounded. So if it is a linear, this one is physical region of linear inequalities is bounded. That is the it should be enclosed within the circle. All the points should be enclosed within the circle. Okay. So then only it is bounded. Otherwise, it is unbounded. Okay. So this ABCD is bounded. So 0, 0. So we have to substitute which is equals to 0. So what about this 25, comma 0? So z is equals to the x value is 25, which is equals to 25, and it has 3, 20, 10. So 20, 10 substitute. This z is equals to that is x value is 10, 20, y value is 10, which is equals to 30. And this card is serial number 4. So 0 comma 20. Okay. So z is equals to, substitute x is equals to 0, y is equals to 20. It is equals to 20. Among all these values, which is the maximum? Okay. So the maximum value is by looking in the function of, that is 30. The maximum value is 30 at the point 20, 10. at least on last point you have to write conclusion, that is called conclusion, you have to write. Hence, the maximum value is 30, hence maximum value. We just to write this like this, maximum. Maximum value is 30. At the point, where it is going to be 30? At the point, okay, you will get the marks for this also. Conclusion also, you will get for 1 marks. For conclusion, students will skip the conclusion. Don't forget to write the conclusion. For conclusion also, you will get 1 marks. Getting this corner points is 3 marks, that is 4 marks. Okay, writing this corner points is 1 marks. And just checking this ABCD is bounded. You draw all the lines, inequalities on this graph, okay? That is for 1 marks. If the feasible region is correct, then only you will get all the values. Otherwise, you are not getting the values, okay? You are not getting the marks, not values, marks. If the points, if this line is correct, you will get one marks, that too according to the scheme of valuation, according to the validators, scheme of validators. So for that also you may get 0 marks, okay? If you draw this line like this, okay? Okay? If the feasible region is not correct also, if your lines are correct, the inequality slides are correct, you may get 1 marks. If the feasible region, this part is not correct, you won't get any marks, you will get 0 marks, okay? So you have to be very careful for this. For next problem. So this is 6 marks, okay, question. Next. Minimize and maximize. Minimize and maximize. Minimize and maximize. Z is equals to x plus 2y subject to the constraints. Subject to the constraints. X plus 2y greater than or equals to 100. 2x minus 5 less than or equals to 0. 2x plus 5 less than or equals to 200. xy greater than or equals to 0. by graphical method. Okay, by graphical method. So this is the very important problem. Okay, it came in the examination. It already came in the examination. So these are all important problems. Okay, you'll get 6 marks very easily in the examination if you understood this properly. Okay. And first, what we have to write? We have to first draw the line of the equation. In the equation, this one, no, that is equation 1. So 2, so 3, and this one is 4. Okay. So draw the line of this x plus 2y is equals to 100. Okay. So what is this? X value, y value. If I substitute x is equals to 0, you will get y. 2y is equals to 100. That is 2 ones are, 2 5s are. You will get x is equals to 0, y is equals to 50, and y is equals to 0, you will get x is equals to 100. Okay. After this sum, this equation is true. This 0 is greater than or equals to 0. This after this is 0 greater than or equals to 100. This 0 is greater than or equals to 100, which is false. Okay? So if it is false, the solution does not contain towards the origin. The half plane is away from the origin. The half plane is going to be away from the origin. For example, this is the graph of this line. So here it is origin, no? So it is going to be away from the origin. Okay? Like this. Away from the origin is you have to put the lines like this, okay? So away from the origin, the half plane, you have to write all the sentences. The half line is away from the origin. What about this one? This is very important, okay? This second equation is very important. You can consider 2x minus 5 less than x equals to 0. I will put x is equals to 0, y is equals to 1. Okay, what will happen in this equation? That is equals to 0 minus 1 less than or equals to 1. So minus 1 less than or equals to 0. So this one is true, no? This minus 1 is less than or equals to 0. So which is true? Okay, which is true. So it means to say that the half plane is towards the y axis here, because the half plane, if I substitute x is equals to 0, we won't hit value. See, it is true, it does not towards the x axis, it is towards the y axis. Okay. For example, if I substitute x is equals to 1 and y is equals to 0, what will happen? So 2 of 1 minus 0 less than or equals to 0. So 2, that is 2 minus, this is 2 minus 0 less than or equals to 0. 2 is less than or equals to 0. Is this equation is true? No, it is not true, because 2 is greater than 0. So here the solution contains does not towards the x axis. If I say, because x is 1 here, it does not contains towards the x axis. Actually, it is towards the y axis here. The solution contains towards the y axis. You have to be very careful about this equation. Okay? If this equation is like this, you have to try like this. So this is towards the y axis. Towards the y axis. So you are going to get the straight line. It is this passing through the origin. That line you will get like this. Okay? Like this you get. You will get confusion whether you have to put the below the line, above the line, which is below or which is above. You will get confusion. So it is towards the y axis. then you won't get any confusion. It is towards the y-axis. What about this next one? Next equation is this now. 2x plus y. So x is equals to 0, you think y is equals to 200. So x is equals to 0, y is equals to 200. Y is equals to 0, you think x is equals to 100. 2 ones are 100. So this equation is true, okay? Because this 0 is less than or equals to 200, which is equals to 2. The solution contains towards the origin. In this, the solution contains towards the origin. For this, we have to draw the graph, okay? We have to draw the graph, which is the first equation. So, first equation is this one, no? X, what is this? X is equals to 0. X is equals to 0, y is equals to 50. Y is equals to 0, x is equals to 100, is it correct? So this equation also, we have to, for this we have to write the table also after this, okay? We have to write the table. So for this 2x, we transpose this minus y to RHS, we get 2x is equals to 1. If I substitute x is equals to 1, that is 2 of 1, which is equals to y, you will get y is equals to 2. If I substitute x is equals to 5, you will get y is equals to 2 of 5, which is equals to 10. It means to say that double of the value of this. If x is equals to 10, y is equals to 2 of 10, which is equals to 2 tens of 20. So for this graph is, the table of this graph is like this. So this is x value, x is equals to 3, because we take this y, so y is equals to 10. What will happen if we take x is equals to 10, you will get y is equals to 20. If I take x is equals to 30, you will get, that is a double of this, no? 3 times 6, which is equals to 60. Because 2x is equals to y, if it is x is equals to 30, 3 times 60. What will happen if x is equals to 40? I will get 2 of 40, 4 2 is 8, you will get the value of y is equals to 18. You will get like this, okay? For this, the first equation is true, no? The first equation is true. It is the first equation. This equation is true. This is towards the y-axis. You have to remember this, towards the y-axis. And this equation is also true. If it is true, the solution contains towards the origin. If it is not true, the solution does not contain towards the origin. Okay. So the graph is very, very important here, because there are more than three equal inequalities are there, no? So like x plus 2y. What is this graph? Z is equals to x plus 2y. Okay. So x is equals to 0, 50, 100, 0, 5, 10, 20, 20, 30, 40, x 200. And then you say, okay. So how you are going to put the scale? That is 20, 40. Okay, we will better put this 20. What are the x values into x values? 10, 10, better 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 100. Okay. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, this one is 100. We have to change the scale, okay? according to the these points, y axis up to 200, you need to go for 20, 40, 60, 80, so also you get 100, 120, 140, so that is, you can change this, no? You can just go back to this is 20, 40, 60, 80, this 100, 120, 140, 160, 180, 200. Okay? Change the scale according to this because the y axis value is what? This x is equals to 0, y is equals to 200. So just again, the first equation is this now. X is equals to 0, y is equals to 50. It is going to become here, okay? 50. This x value is 100. Here, 100 comma 0. Here, 50 comma 0 comma 50. Join the parentheses, okay? So, this is below the line of the solution contains towards the origin. The solution contains towards the origin. Go for the second term. Second equation is 0 to 100. Yeah. 0 to 100. To better immediately the coordinates of the point, next 100. 100 is here. Join the lines like this. So it is going away from the origin. This is also true. This equation is also true. So if it is true, just draw the lines. And this equation, the middle equation, x is equals to 5, y is equals to 10. X is equals to 10, this is equals to 20. If it is 20, it is going to be 40, no? Double of this. If it is 30, so 60. So if it is 40, it is 80. Okay. It is like this, okay? So I have told you this is towards the y-axis. This shaded part is towards the y-axis. Okay. The first equation is x is equals to 100, no? So this is this equation is not true. It is correct, no? This is true. This is false. This is false, okay? So if it is false, this is the first line, no? What we got is this, okay? This is the first line. So if it is false, the shaded part is going to be like this, okay? The shaded part is going to be like this. You have to remember that, okay? See, the first equation is like this, that is false, like this, okay? So, okay, I will write it here because we will get confusion about this, okay? I'll just write here, okay? Simplification. The first equation is like this now. So the shaded part is going to be like this, right? What about this? This is the second equation, is passing through the origin, okay? So the shaded part is going to be like this, towards the y axis, okay? Towards the y axis. What about this equation? This equation is 0 to 200 to here, okay? It is going to be this. Here it is going to be, okay? So the shaded part is going to be here because the solution contains towards the origin, okay? Here. So we have to check which is the common point here, which is the common point. See, don't get confusion about this. This is the first equation. The shaded part is this, put the lines like this. Because the solution does not contain the origin, so like this. Which is the second equation?
Second equation is this, no?
Second equation is this. This is the first equation. This is the second equation. So this is first. This is second. So like this. Towards the y-axis. What about the third equation? Third graph is here, no? So it is below the line. So you need to be very careful. So where is going to be all the points are going to satisfy here? Where is going to meet all the three shaded parts? So here, no, which is part, no? The common region for all the three constraints. So because now see this is first, okay, and the second one is here. So this will join, and the third one is here. So here, okay. So like this, and like this, and like this, okay. So here it is going to be made, okay. So this is the shaded. So this is the physical region. Physical region is solution region. So if the physical region is correct, then only you get the graph. Otherwise you won't get graph. Okay. So after this, this equation. After this, you have to find out these common points now. So common points are very, very important, okay? So here this is 50. 50 will come. And here this is just check it, okay? 100 will come. Just check the common points, okay? Just draw the graph and check the common points. So I'll tell you the common points for this equation. Z is equals to x plus 2y. And the common points are this point 0, 200, and this point, and that is 0, 50, okay? 0, 50, and this point, okay? This is 20, okay? If it is correct, 20, 40. And this one, okay, this one is the 50, okay, 50. This is 20, 40. So the last one is 50, and it is going to be 100, okay, someone just check it, okay, it is going to be 100. So 50, 100. So these are the corner points, okay. I sent you the notes also, okay, you get exact corner points here. So just check it, this is 20, it has to be correct only. So this x-axis, towards x-axis is 20, and y-axis is 40, and this is 50, it has to be correct, okay? The line should be correct, then you will get exact corner points. That is equals to 50, you will get 100 here, okay? This is 100, so here you get some of this, okay? If your graph is correct, you will get, okay, this is 100, it's there. So 50, 100, okay. So this is, you have to be very careful. This is 100, y-axis is 100, This is 50 and this is 20, 40, 50, 100, 0, 200 and what about this one, 0, 50. These are the corner points, okay. So after that getting corner points, we have to find out by using this z is equals to x plus 2y, we have to get this optimal value, that is which has to be any point in the feasible region is going to tell the maximum and minimum point, okay. That is the optimal value definition. Any point in the feasible region has to be maximized or minimized, okay. This is called optimal value. So if it is 0, 0, you will get 0 only for this, which one? For this point, z is equals to, okay, 0, 50, 20, 40, 50, 100, okay. So if it is this one, so 0, 200, here 0, 200, that is 2 of y value is 200, it is equals to 400 degree. If it is 0, 200, next 0, 50, okay, that is x value is 0, y value is 50, it is equals to 100 degree. And for 20, 40 means x value is 20, y value is 2 of 40. So 20 plus 4 plus 8, which is equals to 100. So you will get 200 here. 2 minimum points you get. Minimum point is 100, 100. This is minimum. And maximum is 400. Here, hence, they're asking to find both minimum and maximum values, okay. Hence, the minimum value is 400 at the point 2 comma this one, which is at the point 0 comma 200. Here it is, we get maximum value at 400, no? We get 400 at the point 0 comma 200. This minimum value is 100, 100, okay. We get two minimum values at the common points, and maximum value is 400 at 0, 200. At last you write the conclusion. Minimum value is 100 at the points. There are two minimum values, no? You just write the corner points, and the maximum value is 400 at the point 0, 200. Okay, this is the conclusion. You try to solve the problems. Okay, I have sent you the notes also. This is graph notes, linear programming problems, graph notes. You just take the graph sheet. I told you already in the beginning classes, you will provide the graph sheet for this. You will get exactly this values. Okay, this corner point values, you will get it exactly. But you have to be very careful. Okay, this intersection of the two boundary lines. Okay. So you will get exactly this point, and here immediately after drawing this, you put the values, the coordinates of the points. Here also you put the coordinates of the points. So those are the coordinates of the points. Okay. After getting corner points, substitute this corner points values in this z is equals to x plus 2y. In this graph, you will get 400 is the maximum value, and the minimum value is 100 at the two corner points. Okay, you just write the conclusion like that. So try to solve the graph. Okay.